Get ready to match the stars. Alan Ludden, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Dolly Martin, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play in the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now, here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
How are you doing? How are you doing there? Around.
I made a propeller.
Oh, you made a propeller?
Did it work? Yes, it worked. That's how Leonardo da Vinci started.
That's right. He propelled himself right out of his seat, didn't he? Right.
The only thing I'm sorry about is she didn't fly away on it.
Are you all ready, folks? You ready, Richard?
Ready.
All right. Shall we say hello to our two players, Maxine Lambeth and Jerry James? All right, Maxine.
Fine.
Maxine's the current champ. She's won $2,850. She's being challenged by Jerry. We're in the middle of round two. Are we in the middle of round two? Starting in middle of round two. Is that where we are? Are you sure?
Yeah.
My memory says we...
Yeah.
No, I guess that's right. Okay, it's 4-0, and you got to match four celebrities to stay in the game, 5 to win. And we'll find out how that turns out right after we find out about this.
No.
Here we are, friends. I push this little button here, and this is yours. You ready?
It's mine.
4 to tie, 5 to win. Dr. Pullum the dentist.
Dr. what?
Dr. Pullum the dentist.
Oh. Isn't that cute?
You remember reading about him in Joe Miller's? Anyway, Dr. Pullum the dentist is really kooky. When you go to him for a checkup, he says, "Don't bother opening your mouth. I'll check your teeth by looking in your blank." It's a goofy doctor dentist type here. Says, "Don't bother opening your mouth. I'll check your teeth by looking in your blank." All right. Do not think too hard, Charles. You'll strain something and never work again.
Honey, that's been strained so long.
Charles, you've been very subdued these last few days. Is everything all right?
Haven't.
Yes. I don't want to. Oh, you're all ready. What are you doing down there, you
nothing.
Rotten person?
I'm not doing anything.
Yes.
What was she doing down there?
Shaving my legs is what she was doing. All right, Maxine. Dr. Pullum the dentist is really kooky. When you go to him for a checkup, he says, "Don't bother opening your mouth. I'll check your teeth by looking in your blank."
I've got two answers, but since you've got two ears and teeth on the side, I'm going with ears.
Ears. Okay, she says ears. He's 4 to tie, 5 to win. All right, Alan, she's looking for ears.
She needs 4 to tie.
5 to win.
And 5 to win.
Yes, that's 10 ears altogether.
She's on her way with one.
All right. Two ears. Brad, you give that lady some ears?
She's falling by the wayside rapidly.
Really?
I said neckline.
Don't bother to check your mouth. Don't bother opening your mouth. I'll check your teeth by looking in your neckline.
No, they wear those little old V-necks.
Yeah.
Pete right. Down there.
Yeah. Right.
George, you thought it was Gene Rayburn.
Yes, that's right. What do you say, Charles?
I want a different route.
Yes.
Bank book.
Bank book. I'll check your teeth by looking in your bank book. Now, she's got to match all the remaining celebrities to stay in the game, and...
My dentist always does this because he don't think I got anything in there so he can see it easier. Ears.
Ears. Well, that's two. Now, Richard, this little lady is looking for some ears.
Can you explain Charles' answer?
Well...
Can you explain Brett's?
Can you explain Brett's? Let's say 11...
If you can't say Brett, don't even answer the question.
Can I do it one at a time?
Yeah.
Yes. Should we take
bank
Charles first?
Book?
Yes. Well, you see... There is a joke.
Excuse me a second. Ears.
All right. That's
three. Look at
ears. One more ear ties the score, and if you don't match Betty, though, Jerry James will win. All right, Betty White, you're up.
So I'm the villainess now.
You are the villainess.
I wish Brett were sitting here. I would give anything to Brett.
Maybe you can change seats and show your answer.
But she might not have said ears.
Yeah. You almost said nose?
Yes, I'm so glad I said ears.
Yes, I'm so glad I said ears. Listen, when they screened you in the office to come in here and play the game, didn't they say, try and get a little, excited about it and pretend you're enjoying it?
If they knew me, they would have said, sit still.
All All right, so we've got a tie. We'll wipe the slate clean, push the button, reveal the two tie-breaking questions, one for each. The one who scores the most will be the winner. Jerry, you make a selection.
Me, please.
All right, everybody plays the tiebreaker. William was supposed to be a judge at the big dog show, but he lost the job when they found out he had blank.
What?
William was supposed to be a judge at the big dog show, but he lost the job when they found out he had...
I got it. Oh, honey. Every once in a while, it becomes crystal clear to me.
Oh.
Why the Lord put me on this...
Oh, no.
That is. That's
right.
The answer.
Here we go. Everybody's ready. Jerry James is up now. William was supposed to be a judge at the big dog show, but he lost the job when they found out he had...
Fleas.
Fleas is a good answer. Let's hear it for the fleas.
My dog has fleas.
My dog has fleas.
How do you feel?
I still love my answer.
What do you say?
Fleas, naturally. Well, the 5-8 finally came through.
Yeah.
Right?
Listen, all dogs have fleas. Look at Betty. I said she had rabies.
Rabies. Charles, your dog has fleas?
Fleas.
Two for Jerry. What do you say, Dolly?
Distemper.
You say distemper.
Right,
we're putting
darling.
You on the first boat to Liverpool. What do you say, Richard?
And I'll meet you at the captain's table. Rabies.
Rabies.
Oh, it's all right when Dick says rabies.
Yeah.
When I say rabies.
It's reasonable. Neckline and bank book for a dentist is absolutely bizarre.
That's right. You're not going to sleep tonight over
no,
there.
No, I'm certainly not. I'm going to talk to them.
All
don't
right,
talk
Betty
to me.
White.
I'm not speaking to you.
This looking is for the answer, fleas.
I'm still looking for the answer, fleas. This is a very mangy answer.
Mange. So that's two for you. Hey. Now you need two to tie, three to win. Here we go. Lorenzo said to his psychiatrist, I've never felt so humiliated in my entire life. This morning, I was blanked out of clown school. That's what Lorenzo said to his psychiatrist.
Now, what did Lorenzo do?
Lorenzo said to his psychiatrist, I've never felt so humiliated in my entire life. This morning, I was blanked out of clown school.
Does that question make sense? Tell
no, it doesn't.
It
none of the questions.
Very good sense.
Makes sense. Charles.
Should I see your answer?
Charles, you mean you finally understood a question?
Yes.
This show is in a heap of trouble. If Charles finally understood a question.
We didn't meet. I'm Cedric Martin.
You're Cedric Martin.
The ticket booth is closed, but if you take this receipt to the blue counter.
Are you ready? Have you met the ingenue?
No.
You haven't. You're going to love her. Yes.
Now, she's right over there, darling.
That's right. Are you ready over here?
Do your clothes ever shrink?
No, my clothes never shrink.
That's nice.
You did one, and he did the other one while I was talking to Charles.
You couldn't tell the difference?
Oh, does this go on when I'm not here?
Yeah. What's that? You forgot the question?
Yeah,
oh,
now tell
I'll read it again. Lorenzo said to a psychiatrist, I've never felt so humiliated in my entire life. This morning I was blanked out of clown school.
Kicked out.
Kicked out of clown school.
That was good.
The jury is not decided yet. Alan?
Now, this takes a little loose treatment, but given the proper looseness, this could match.
Really?
I would think it was a
We'll be the judge of that.
You'll be the judge of that? Washed.
Washed out? That kicked out? Washed out? Well, they're not exactly alike.
Kicked
I wouldn't imagine.
Washed out, same thing.
But I don't own the show, so that's the way it is. What do you say?
Want to see my tank watch?
Yes.
Well, darling, I said drummed. They have drummed.
Drummed out?
Drummed out is the same as washed out, kicked out.
Isn't it? Yeah.
Discarded.
Okay. Right. One more, you win the game, Maxine, Charles.
This is a terrific answer.
Yes.
Laughed out.
Laughed out. That is a terrific answer. Clown was laughed out of school because he was a rotten clown. All right, Dolly, she's looking for kicked out of clown school.
This is what the audience do to me often. Booed out.
booed out. No match there. She'll get you in the parking lot later. Vicious karate champ.
They're singing our song.
Richard?
Of course, washing all that drummed maybe, but I always like to match the word kicked with kick.
Kick. That works again. $100 for you. We congratulate you. And we're sorry to say goodbye to Jerry James.
That's fun.
We've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being on
Thank
Match
you.
Game 75. Jerry James. All right, while he's going out, we'll spin this little commercial for you, and then you hurry right back. Here's a little lady who has $2,950 and is going to try for over $5,000 now. And if you get the five G's, you know what you have to do.
Okay.
All right. We polled a recent studio audience, Maxine, got their best response to this. Going blank. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it, $250 if you match a middle one, $100 if you match a bottom one. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Going, gone.
That wasn't my answer. Alan.
I had going. Going my way.
Going my way, the opening card be flipped.
Brett.
What do you say, Brett?
Oh, I just think about my youth. How about going steady?
Going steady? You like that one?
Yes, going steady.
And that's the one you're going to pick?
That's what I'm going to pick.
All right, it's yours. You got it, Maxine. Going steady is what she is looking for. Naturally, she hopes it's under the $500 response, but we're going to begin at the bottom as usual. And reveal the $100 response. Going, gone. That was up there, given to you by Richard. Here is the $250 response. Going my way.
Oh.
All right. That was Alan Ludden's answer. Last chance for going steady. Here's the $500 response. Would you like a little kiss?
No, I'm only kidding.
Listen, Maxine, you now have $3,450, and you're going to play for 10 times 500 or 5,000. Remember, you have to match one celebrity head-to-head. Which one will it be?
Brett.
Okay, Brett, get ready to write.
I like her dress.
You like her dress?
It's really a nightie.
You ready?
No, right. But go ahead.
Turn around and face me if you would, please. Here we go. Forest blank. F-O-R-E-S-T blank. Forest blank. Forest blank.
Okay.
Now she's finished. Maxine, we ask you to give us an answer, one you think will match hers. Forest.
I'm sorry to say this, but Forest Lawn. I don't know if that's an advertisement or not.
Forest Lawn. All right, she says that'll match you for $5,000. Brett, what do you say?
Oh, I'm sorry. I said Forest Fire.
Forest Fire. What's that?
He's right.
She's right?
Yes.
One of us is wrong here. So.
I had Tucker.
Okay. Well, I'm sorry you didn't win the $5,000, but you still got your $3,450. You're going to play another game, Maxine. Let's welcome Cindy Williams. You ladies know each other, don't you? Now, Cindy Williams, let's find out who you are.
Okay. I'm originally from Abilene, Texas, but for the last 4 years I've lived in Austin. I graduated from the University of Texas at Austin in July of 1974, and I've been teaching eighth grade for the last year. I teach English and journalism, Munchkins.
Did she say she was in the eighth grade or teaching the eighth grade?
Thank you. My students often ask me that question, too.
Turn up your hearing aid, Brett. Well, what is, you said you teach English
and journalism, communications.
Yeah.
I was a yearbook sponsor and newspaper sponsor, photography club sponsor, you name it.
Jean, well, you're a busy lady, yes.
Do you interview all these ladies? They're so pretty. Do you do it?
No, I never see them really until they spin out here.
Mm,
no, I don't.
That's your story.
No, I have
He calls
to do
on them personally,
They're
though.
All very lovely. All right, Cindy, if you're ready, we'll ask you to make a selection.
Okay, A, please.
A. She wants A.
Practice.
Playing for Abilene.
Tell us why they say that A down there, Alan.
Yes, that's the way you talk in the University of Texas.
I see.
I'm going to match her. Okay. Now watch.
Alan Ludden said, My wife, Betty White, treats me like a dog. For my birthday, she gave me a blank. My wife, Betty, treats me like a dog. For my birthday, she gave me a blank. Ready? We're just funning you.
They're just joshing us.
Yes. Splendid. Okay, Cindy Williams. Alan Ludden said, my wife, Betty White, treats me like a dog. For my birthday, she gave me a...
bone?
A bone.
Gene, I don't see how a pretty University of Texas graduate like that could think that the wife of a distinguished alum like me could be given such a tacky present as that.
I don't understand it either.
But knowing the University of Texas, yeah. I said, bone.
That's a match. That's one for you.
Oh, thank you.
All right, Brett.
Alan and I are going to Hawaii. Now's the time to tell you, and you're staying home with a bone.
Okay. Charles?
Bone!
Bone. That's two bones. No, three. There you go. Hey, listen, will you wake up back there? Who's ever keeping scores? He's got three. Okay. Dolly, you're up.
Bone!
That's four bones. And here we come.
Do you find drinking during the day helps, Alan?
It all depends who you have to work with.
What he was saying.
Exactly, Alan.
For my birthday, she gave me a blank, and the lady said bone.
I choose column I, bone.
Bone! Five bones!
I don't know how to explain this, but you see, I don't believe in giving dogs bones because sometimes it causes... Pardon me, sir. I said she gave him a goodie. I'm sorry.
You're the only one who didn't match.
I know it, and I'm so sorry.
Holy mackerel. Okay, Cindy, that's five for you. Your question comes up a little later. Right now, this for you.
Buzzer Play-Doh.
Here we go. All right. Ready?
Ready.
You know what you have to do?
Oh, yes.
All right, you got to work hard here. Dr. Welby said, Consuela, this lunch tastes awful. And Consuela said, that isn't your lunch, doctor. You're eating Mr. Harris's blank. You hear all that, Maxine?
Yes.
Okay. I'm not going to answer that question.
Yes, you've got to play.
No, I'm not going to play this one.
Oh, yes. You can't sit out. Consuela said this lunch tastes awful. Consuela said that isn't your lunch, doctor. You're eating Mr. Harris's blank. Okay. All right. Come on now, that's an easy one there. Marvelous choices there. Amusing choices. Serious choices.
We have another category.
Yes. Charles, will you hurry up? Here we go. Maxine. Dr. Welby said, Consuela, this lunch tastes awful. And Consuela said, that isn't your lunch, doctor. You're eating Mr. Harris's blank.
Heart.
Heart.
Could have been anything.
Could have been anything, but you said heart, huh? Okay, what do you say?
Well, I was afraid of something she was going to say.
Yeah.
And I didn't want to say it.
Naturally.
But I wanted to say something that would match it.
Yes.
So I said, quote, sample, end quote.
Okay. All right. Carry on. All right, troops. Brett. Into the breach.
All right, my darling. Once more, eat your heart out because I said liver.
Liver. Looking for a little heart here, Charles.
I wanted to... What was his name, Mr.?
Dr. Welby.
Dr. Welby, for heaven's sake.
You're eating Mr. Harrison's blank.
I wanted to keep Mr. Harrison alive, so I said appendix.
Appendix.
Parmesan.
Parmesan. Appendix Parmesan, no. Ah, che bella. Oh, hello there.
Hello.
Yes.
I did think of heart, come to think of it.
You did think of heart.
But I didn't put it down.
What did you put down?
Because he would have died, right?
Yes.
I didn't want him to die, so I said kidney.
Kidney.
Would he have died if he'd had his kidney?
Oh, no, he'd be fine without
kidney. He'd be fine. You only need one kidney. He could eat one kidney. Guy wouldn't even miss it. There, would he? What do you say there? Oh,
appendix a la mode.
Appendix a la mode, yeah.
Al deserto.
All right. Are you offering something special? What's in the special today?
Well, you can have... No, I will not. Liver and tonsils or liver and onions?
With a little bacon and onions fried up, okay.
I'm embarrassed.
End of round one, 5-0, favor of Cindy Williams, our challenger. Round two coming up after this message.
Attention, is your E3.
Round two coming up next time we all get together. We'll look forward to it, ladies. Thank you for being with us. 5-0 the score in favor of the challenger. Listen, you were all just dandy. Well,
with
everybody
one exception.
Was dandy. But you're going to get worse. So.
Should I issue a formal apology?
No,
all right. Okay.
You're such a neat kid, a peachy dresser and a snappy dancer and all that.
Hey, this show is as fun to work on as it is to watch on television.
You watch this show at home?
Yeah, you bet.
You're the one. She watches the show at home. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Gibson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast. Stay tuned for musical chairs next over most of these CBS stations.